resignation. If you accept the resignation, it becomes effective today upon acceptance. And he would then switch to holding the office as a holdover until you appoint someone to replace him, which is one of the options that you have. If you did not accept the resignation, it would become effective 8 days after it was received, even if it has a request for a future date. That 8th day would be tomorrow. So if you didn't take any action, then the resignation would be effective tomorrow, and then you would switch to being a holdover. The election code does say that you may not refuse to accept the resignation. So by law, you can't reject it, but if you took no action, it would become effective tomorrow, irregardless, because tomorrow would be the 8th day.
Do you have any comments, Councilman Jennings?
No.
Council. So I've seen a request by John to have his spot be filled by the next meeting, which is the week from Tuesday, the 8th. And then I've also seen in our packet that a request to be able to get information out there that would be the November meeting. So if we don't fill his seat on October 8th, then you're saying he stays in the seat until we fill his seat?
Yes, if you waited till the November meeting, then he would could attend that meeting. You can't force him to, but he could. And until whoever you appoint is sworn in with their oath of office, he could participate as the alderman until that oath is done, and then the new person would take his seat.
Councilman?
What does the holdover thing actually mean?
There's a provision in the Texas Constitution which its stated purpose is to provide for the efficient and continuing operation of government. And so what it generally provides is if somebody resigns, they must still fulfill the duties of their office until their successor takes office, whether it be by appointment or by election. But it's to prevent vacancies.
Take an action or don't take an action, tomorrow it will be effective evening. His resignation will be accepted either by vote tonight or by default tomorrow.
Correct.
Where does the holdover come into that?
That kicks in as soon as the resignation is effective.
And if he was to serve into the November, though he lives outside or will live outside of the city limits, he can still be an active member of the council.
Yes, that's one thing I've been trying to find as much information on as possible, because it kind of defies logic that if you don't live here anymore, you should be able to participate. The holdover provision is the general rule, and so for it not to apply, you have to find an exception that says it doesn't apply. For example, if you pass away, it obviously doesn't apply. If you're convicted of a crime and lose your office because you're convicted of a crime, then that's another example of an exception to the holdover provision.
Any other questions? This is not number six, which is regarding the procedure for billing. This is consider and taking action necessary regarding the resignation of John Jennings. Is there a motion from the council at this time?
I make a motion that we accept his resignation as written and that we proceed to refill his seat on October 8th.
Can we take a motion to refill that position now since we have not done regarding the procedure and it's not in a, on the agenda? Can you go ahead and do that?
Well, deciding what procedure to use, I think, is the next item on the agenda.
Yes.
You could ask that the items be taken up for consideration together. That way it could be combined into one motion. Otherwise, you would just move to accept and then under the next agenda item, make a motion in regards to the request that's in this letter.
So,
if I accept his resignation as written, I'm accepting it as the terms that he's written it as, which his resignation states that he is requesting that his seat be refilled on October the 8th.
You can make your motion with that stipulation if that's part of your willingness to accept it.
Is there a second?
I have a question.
Well, you should have a discussion in the second.
Okay.
Wait, well, let's see if we have a second. I need a second for that motion. Second call for a second for that motion. Third and final call for a second for that motion. It is defeated by, for the lack of a second. This item is back on the floor. Councilman Jennings, what is your question?
I have one question, ma'am. My question was going to be, I'm obviously not going to vote in favor of my resignation because I submitted it. I'm in favor of that. But if it was a two-part motion, could I vote on, I would vote on the portion to fill the seat on October 8th.
But if he's done it as a whole thing.
Right. Well,
so
I would vote,
it was defeated for that. So we're back to item five, consider and take any action necessary regarding resignation of John Jennings. Are there any other motions regarding item five?
I move that we accept his resignation.
Is there a second?
I'll second that.
Is there a discussion? Councilman Clayton?
No, ma'am.
Councilman Moore?
No.
Councilman Jennings? All those in favor? Please raise your hand. Opposed? Abstained? Four in favor, one abstained.
How can he abstain whenever it's he has to recuse himself?
He is not still on the council and cannot vote?
He is still on the council.
I am still on the council, but I submitted the resignation. I don't believe I would have to accept it.
Abstaining is the same as not voting. That's
right.
What an abstention is.
Thank you.
But he's not required to, since it involves himself, he's not required to recuse himself. I know whenever I was up for the EDC, I couldn't comment or vote because it involved me.
Well, that is appointing yourself to
So this is you know, the same thing, I think, in reverse. Should he not be, for this particular motion, not be involved in this action?
This motion is passed. Are you considering, adding six?
Strictly the motion that we accept the resignation.
No, because the conflict is the state law prevents self-appointment. And that's what the the conflict law was that governed your situation. There's not one that would apply to this. This isn't self-appointment.
But he submitted the letter to resign.
Yeah, there's no self-appointment, there's no dual office holding, there's no business interest, there's no property ownership, and there's no conflicting loyalties with another entity. Those are your basic conflict of interest laws. I don't think any of those apply to this particular situation.
So you say that is legal, what we have just done?
Well, and abstaining is declining to participate.
Okay. Item number 6, consider and take any action necessary regarding the procedure for filling the vacancy. Councilman Blake, do you have any comments on this item?
Well, I have a question. I don't know that I want to have somebody come in and fill his position, because that gives them an unfair advantage in the next election, in a way, because they've already served in that position. Is there, what would you do if you just wanted to let him go ahead and serve out the term, you know, till the end of the thing? But that, is there a legal way to do that, or you just don't appoint somebody and that does that, or what?
You could not appoint somebody. That is what the council did when Mr. Mosby submitted a resignation. They didn't take action on it. The risk that you run in doing that to the city, if something happens to someone else and they can't be a council member anymore, now you're down to 3.
Right.
If you have 2 vacancies, you can no longer fill them by appointment, so you're left with 3 until the next election, and special called meetings, you could not have them because you have to have 4. You have to have a supermajority to have a quorum for a special called meeting, and it leaves the city with only 3 aldermen. So that would be one consequence of not appointing, but it is certainly within your discretion to make that decision.
Okay.
Did that answer your questions?
Yes.
Councilman Moore, do you have any questions regarding this? Do you, Councilman Jennings, have any questions?
Councilman Smith?
No.
Councilwoman Forward?
Yeah, I thought I read in the Attorney General's of Texas thing that it's what we did with A.C. Mosby was illegal, that you cannot not fill a position. And I believe it's highlighted on the copy that I gave you. So I think it does have to be filled.
Did we accept A.C.'s resignation? We never did.
I don't remember if you accepted it or not. If you didn't accept it, it would have become effective on day 8. So the 8th day after he submitted it.
As I recall, we did not accept it. And by law, at day 8, it goes into a holdover. And his entire seat was in holdover position until the May election. And Macy was asked a couple of times to participate in the vote, which he could have done.
Instead of appointing, you also have the right to choose that the vacancy should be filled by election. Unfortunately, in this case, we now only have 2 uniform election dates, November and May. In order to have filled the vacancy by election at the November 5th election date, you would have had to have ordered the election by August 26th. You could choose to fill it by election, but that has the practical effect if the election would not occur until May, because that's the first election date that you could lawfully call the election.
That part of it, yes. Now, I would like to also consider the idea that we have in the packet of going out to the public and seeing who would be interested in filling the position and wait until the November council meeting to do that.
If they, I have a question, if they do that, are they obligated to accept, there still isn't a, I don't really know how to phrase this, but there's still not an obligation that they would take those applications and accept one of them. Am I right in that?
That is correct.
That does not make an obligation, even though if they choose that type of procedure.
You are, yes.
You're saying if we had five people apply and we didn't like, we personally, it didn't count, so didn't want to serve with any of those five people? Okay, yeah.
That's exactly what I'm asking. If you get five applications and you do not feel like that any of the five are suited, you have the right to reject that and continue on.
You could even appoint someone who did not apply. I mean, that's within your discretion if you wanted to nominate somebody.
I would like to make a comment in that I have, by all laws that I'm required to do, notified the city and the mayor that my resignation. And it's not in the best interest of the city or the mayor or anyone else to delay any longer than what I've requested in my letter. You know I will not be a resident on the 25th of October. I have asked if you feel at the next regular council meeting, which is, falls into the days of the time limit by law, falls into the next council, replaces me, still as a resident, voting on the council, which I can by law do, to go past the 25th and into November, there's nothing that could risk on the city of other circumstances coming involved, because I will be a legal voting member of the council.
I think it would give us...
I make a motion that we add this to the agenda for next week to replace my seats, all three of the city council, by vote of the council at that time.
I second.
Discussion. Any further discussion?
Okay, if will people get a chance to, is it legal if you just put something on the website saying, you know, if you want to sign up for a pot, you know, to do that between now and then, and what would you have to have your thing in 3 days before the 8th or to be on the thing or the night of?
Yeah, it's fine. You could certainly put it on the website and, you know, give directions to Frey to however you want him to promote it.
And the leader, but the leader does not come out until the Thursday before the council meeting on Tuesday.
Well, it would come out, I mean, if we knew it now, if you put it in Wednesday, it would show up in Sundays. I mean, this Friday's, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
I think if we get it in now, we could get it in by that. Yeah, I guess it would be okay to me as long as Frank tried everything that we could to get as much information out about it so that the average citizen could know about it and be able to apply for it and tell them they had to have their application in by the 5th, I guess, or the 4th, or what?
That Friday before the council meeting to meet the town.
Yeah, they need to get it, if you want them in your packets.
Yeah, okay.
So your comments, Councilman Moore?
That's my,
I'm sorry, were you finished? Okay. I'm going for comments.
Yeah. That works.
Okay. Councilman Jennings?
No, I feel that my phone began ringing Saturday. It was public knowledge very quickly after our meeting by the afternoon. It's obvious by the citizens that are in here tonight. So I think it's very reasonable and it's the best interest of the city.
Councilman
Smith?
I think we need to have proper publication of the vacancy and accept applications.
I think we need more time on this, and I think November 8th is a very good time. We're talking 2 weeks beyond the time when Councilman Jennings moves out of the area, there's nothing that's going to happen in the two-week period, time period, that I can see that would cause any disruption to the city.
We have a motion and a second.
Got a question.
You have another?
Can we continue with the questions?
Okay.
Okay.
We have a motion and a second, so we're in discussion.
We went around once, so I'm still discussing.
Okay.
Would, okay, if at the time that it came to, okay, let's say that you did do it on November the 8th instead of October the 8th, or November the 9th, or whatever the day was, the council meeting, then would it still be five of us voting? Would he still be a valid voter on the replacement for him, or would he no longer serve in? Okay, I'm just.
Yes, he's still.
Okay, he would still, would you still be around?
Yes, I will serve as long as I am legally bound to serve. I will serve till May if I'm legally bound to serve. That I have followed the rule of law as I have been advised to do.
Okay. Okay, we have a motion and a second that the item be put on the October, the regular October agenda, and that our city manager, that was not the motion. Okay, this is that it be put on the October agenda, motion and second. All those in favor, please raise your hand. Opposed? Motion carried. I would advise that we do need to get this out publicly as quickly as possible and as soon as possible. That motion passed. Now we have I will now accept a motion to adjourn. Billy Corrigan will make a motion to adjourn. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Russell Moore. All those in favor that we adjourn, please raise your hand. It is unanimous. We are adjourned at 6:55. Thank you very much.
So he is not remaining here. Majority of remaining, he can't, now he's gone. He cannot be in this next election.
And this is, I'm not forced to stay in this place. I don't worry y'all about that. See, I served too long, served on a paper, I don't know my good.
Yeah.
What they do is change the law.
Learning that.
That's good.
What you trying to do? I really don't, like I said, I've only been involved through a few months now, so.
He did, and they didn't have a chance.
I just think it's.
I knew that, because I've seen me and AC before you, and they never did, and they went with.
He doesn't know what it is.
They did. Some of the years I was serving, we had four people. I guess because God is like, he aren't calling me.
Could I have your attention, please, for everybody that's here? In case you have forgotten, Bar 9 is
National Night Out, isn't it? And we would like to see everyone there and support our police department. By the way, what time is it?
Yeah, the street sweepers.
Six to nine, here in the parking lot.
I don't know, if you like got your fantasy football for them.
What I don't understand is how you pick a running back that lives on that fantasy team. We have to beat you down. I said, "Hey, your running back," he's like, "That one for Denver." I'm like, "Well, there you go, he's supposed 4,000 passes a game."
Thank you. I think I'm gonna lose this week. The guy I'm playing has got a...
Yes.
Beat you by 15 points, he's got Drew Brees.
Did you win a game of years?
Well, it's over tonight. I'm winning right now, but his quarterback plays tonight. My take has been carried me, I mean...
The defense is all right, but if you don't go in there and change, do they roll that out of the fire?
No. But you gotta watch, like, if your team has a bye or something, or something gets hurt, or go in and... Try to send someone a trade. I got a couple of them, I'm gonna get them. He's like, I was last year.
From county court, because it's right here by your lap.
Yeah.
He came out and voted on that.
He can't vote nothing.
Someone would probably take him.
But that's what I got from the county.
I started it last year, I love it, it makes football go by.
The drive shaft broke on that truck.
I served him 19 years.
Every truck is in Mansfield or Cleaver.
You don't have, when you turn that...
I have one route that goes all the way to Cleaver.
He ain't got no voter, he ain't got nothing.
All the way out there. And every single one of them.
Be sure if you want a copy of the...
That we break down is out there. Can't be my plane over there.
I mean, where did you get it?
You on mine?
Well, it wasn't in my pack.
I will say, once you get it, disproves this, that I got from the Texas Secretary of State. Says right here in the rules, city council may fill a vacancy by appointment. Majority of remaining, you just resigned, members excluding the mayor may make the appointment until next regular election. You can't vote because you're not, you just resigned.
That's right.
You don't have...
What they require in the position.
By law.
I'll vote next time. My first...
Yeah, we'll go to court with it.
Yeah, we're going to court.
See, it ain't gonna be like what was this. See, but because, see, I took the side, I done the same thing. See, you, like I say, you can't change the law.
Yeah, you're lying, you're a lawyer.
Well, what y'all trying to do is break the law. And I'm gonna say what you know.
You're road styling, so you can get your three in.
Now, we know what you're doing, bud. It's just gonna be something that, bud.
Yeah, your guys are all right now.
Some...
You don't like me?
No, I ain't worried about your money.
Really?
That's right. I'm sure we're lucky.
Well, thank you.
Yes.
You get two guys that have not, haven't been elected.